First things first, let's gather everything you need to file your taxes.
So let's start with the basics, right? Right here. You need the social security number for yourself, your children, your spouse, whoever you're filing for. Over here in this folder, yeah, you're gonna need anything from your employer, your W-2, your 1099. Over here, anything you've given into your retirement accounts or taken out of your retirement accounts, plus any charity you've given. So retirement accounts and charity. And then the final one, in this folder over here, you're going to want everything from your mortgage to property taxes you've paid. You gotta get these write-offs. You gotta get it right.
Okay, now moving on to the really important stuff, your deductions.
Let's first talk about your kids, right? They're finally gonna pay off. You can make some money on them. The child tax credit, I'm sure if you have kids, you've done this before, but don't forget about it. You can get up to $2,000 per child if they're under 17 years old. So I have three kids, Skylar, Sloan, Blake. Skylar's 17 now, so she's aged out of it, okay? She's aged out. 17, it's gotta be under 17. So she's aged out, Sloan's 14. Boom, ka-ching. Blake, he's 12. You're gonna make some money on him too. The child tax credit. You also don't wanna forget about the child care credit. If they're under 13 years old, you can write off a percentage of the money you pay to a child care provider, okay? The babysitter, even summer camp.
Finally, the vehicle you're driving can get you a huge tax credit this year.
If you bought an electric vehicle in 2023, great news, money is coming back to you from the government, anywhere between $3,750 all the way up to $7,500. How much you get depends on a lot of things, right? Your income level, the kind of car you got, where it was manufactured, how the battery was assembled. All those things matter, but so you have some money coming back to you. You can also, if you bought a used electric vehicle in 2023, get up to $4,000 off. Pretty cool. And new this year, this is really cool, if you're out shopping for an EV, okay, and right now, and you haven't bought it yet, you can say to the salesperson, hey, I don't want to wait until tax time. I want you to take that tax credit off the actual price of the vehicle, and they can do that starting this year. Another deduction you may qualify for is the home office deduction. If you use part of your home regularly and exclusively for business-related activity, you can actually write off some of those expenses. But, it's a big but, if you're a W-2 worker, meaning you know you have a full-time job, you have an employer that withholds taxes from your paychecks, you don't qualify for that. I'm going to post more deductions and the qualifications at RossenReports.com. Back to you.